proportion consists of four elements. Two of the elements are known as extremes, and two are known as means. You can remember these terms because if you list them out as A, B, C, and D, both A and D are on the extreme ends. In order to accurately compare a proportion, the cross products must be equal. This means that multiplying the extremes, A times D, must equal the product of the means, B times C. This rule is what allows us to find missing quantities in proportions. We'll show you how it works. Recall that the proportion we set up for Rockport High was 45 students divided by 2 teachers equals X number of students divided by 60 teachers. The first step in solving a proportion is to cross-multiply. In our case, we would multiply the means, 2 times X, and multiply the extremes, 45 times 60. The resulting equation is 2x equals 2,700. Next, divide both sides of the equation by 2 to get x by itself. X equals 1,350. Because we knew the ratio was 45 to 2, students to teachers, and we knew there were 60 teachers, we now know that Rockport High has 1,350 students in the student body. If all these students and faculty can fit in the auditorium at one time, then we have proven that the school can host the competition because they can seat more than 1,200 audience members. Good thing, because it's almost time to start.